Welcome back to KXAN News Today. 6 years ago, Austin began saving the lives of pets as Austin, the city, or rather Pets Alive, became a no-kill shelter. Here to talk about that today is Ellen Jefferson. She's from Austin Pets Alive. And Ellen, you were telling me, you give me some background on this, is that this actually started as a grassroots effort. Tell me about that story.
Well, back in 2008, a lot of citizens got together and wanted to make a difference. The city was at only a 45% save rate, so animals had less than half a chance to get out of the shelter alive. And people got together and started fostering and helping them get out.
So that's what you were seeing, this 45% survival rate. Why was it affecting people so much?
Well, it was the animals that were dying back then were super adoptable. Puppies, kittens, small breed dogs, lots of animals that, I mean, just really had no reason to be put to death.
Yeah, and I guess the question is, what does it say also about a city where the animals only have a 45% survival rate?
Absolutely, yeah.
So now, and then the city came on board after that.
In 2010, the city passed a no-kill resolution to make Austin a no-kill city. And in 2011, we actually hit that goal, and that was a 90% save rate. So 90% of the animals that came into the city shelter made it out alive.
Okay, and then, so that means also to Austin Pets Alive now is a, so then for the city of Austin, is that, does that like give us kind of a special status?
Yes.
What's the banner that we now carry that we love animals?
We are the largest no-kill city in America.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
But are we adopting these animals out? How do they, you know, how do we avoid not killing them?
Well, there's some animals that we have to put to sleep. So those would be the animals that are suffering terribly and really need to be put out of their misery, just like you would with your own pet. Mm-hmm. And there's dogs that are aggressive that aren't safe in our community that also need to be put down at this point. So everything else, though, is just, you know, we have a massive foster program between the city of Austin and our program. We have a ton of fosters. We are always recruiting more. So the capacity of the shelter is only a certain number of cages, but fosters help by housing the animals so that we don't have to put them in cages.
I see. So they at some point eventually find homes.
Oh, yeah.
Because I couldn't imagine somebody bringing this pet in and not falling in love with it.
No, and last weekend, we as a city, between Austin Humane Society, Austin Pets Alive, and the city of Austin, we adopted out 615 animals in one weekend.
In one weekend?
Yeah.
Wow, that's pretty cool. So then to keep that status up, you have to constantly be recruiting volunteers and food. And
Yeah, it takes a community. For sure.
How do you get that? Is it just you have people responding?
Yes, we have a large foster program. We have a large volunteer program. We try to bring people in to be part of the solution. That is the only way we're ever going to be able to stay on top of this, is if lots of people are helping to deal with the number of animals.
How did you know 6 years ago that this could be sustained at least for 6 years?
Well, I moved here because this is an animal-friendly city. I moved here in the 90s, and so it makes perfect sense to me that Austin is the largest no-kill city because we're a community that cares about pets.
And now tonight you guys are going to celebrate. It's like, let's celebrate this. So what are you going to do?
We have a big party at the Palm Door on 6th Street, and we're celebrating the 6th anniversary of being a no-kill city, and the city of Austin will be there. We'll have volunteers there, we'll have staff there, we'll have everybody from the community is welcome. It's just really fun. It's a live band. We give out awards.
And of course, pets are welcome.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much, Ellen Jefferson, for joining me.
Thank you.
All right. And